Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Lee Pitts Live. We're so excited to get them here in the studio. Whenever I do a show with representatives from the Children's Network of Southwest Florida, you see I'm all excited and giddy about it because I've said here numerous occasions over the years that the Children's Network of Southwest Florida and the parents and the families that are associated with putting a net down to protect our children are the heroes in the community. We certainly have some heroes in the community today who are working through the Children's Network. They have adopted two children, ages, right now they're ages 12 and 13, two females, and we want to salute them, Jose and Megan Sanchez, for being heroes in our community. Congratulations on that.
Thank you for having us.
I know you don't think about yourself as a hero. You're just doing what you think is the right thing, and you're benefiting a lot from it. We'll get to that. But I want to go right over here to Tiana. When you hear me say something like that, you wanted the, what's your title again? Quality Management Supervisor. That's a long title. I hope you're getting a lot of money with that long title. But as a quality management supervisor, when you hear me say heroes and you work with people like this, do you think that's the appropriate word?
I think they're the heroes. We are just partnering with them, trying to support them as best as possible, but they are truly the heroes for taking the children in that are in need and deciding to go the extra mile, provide them with permanency through adoption. Mm-hmm.
Nothing more important in society than taking care of our children?
No, I don't think so at all.
Mm-hmm. Having worked at, how many years you've been at the Children's Network?
I've been at the Children's Network since 2015, but I started my career in child welfare over a decade ago.
Mm-hmm. When people, do you, having done this, been around this, do you feel that people still don't realize or don't think about how much we need families and people to be there for these children? There are a lot of children in the system that need to be adopted and foster care. And the more we talk about it, the more the awareness is raised.
I definitely think so. I think it's important for us to continue to have this conversation. Because I feel oftentimes folks think, you know, the next person will do it. But in all honesty, we need everybody to be able to chip in and be a resource for our children in care.
Let's go over here to an adopted family. Husband and wife. How long have you been married?
15 years.
15 years. And I think I'm going to go right to you. How long ago was it that you decided to adopt?
Well, we actually became foster parents about 3 years ago, and we did that. And then we really saw the need for permanency for some of the children waiting in our community, and we decided to adopt about a year ago.
Mm-hmm. How did you come to that conclusion that you wanted to adopt, Jose?
When we see these children and all the needs, they need the love and support from a family. When they don't have that and we can provide it, mm-hmm. why not?
You got that bed, you got that bedroom just sitting
there. We got everything for them. We paint their bedroom in the color that they want, whatever they want, and we can provide it. We give it to them.
That is so beautiful to hear. And talk about, coming back over here to you, Megan, talk about the personal satisfaction you get from knowing that you are doing this and that you're making, giving these children opportunity.
Just being able to see them thrive and see them grow, see their needs met, and see that we're building trust with them, it's what gives us satisfaction. Mm-hmm. Just seeing them flourish and reach milestones and have confidence in themselves. We love that.
Mm-hmm. Now, Jose, you got three ladies in the house now because you adopted two females.
Yeah.
And I'm not mistaken, you didn't have any other children in the house.
We have a foster kid.
Okay.
That is 5 years old with okay. us too. So
also a girl.
Also a girl.
So you in there with all the ladies.
Yeah. When I raise my hand, the boat, it's only one boat.
Pretty every, cool.
Three, yeah, and the dog too. It's a female dog. But I love it. I love it. It's a family. You know, we're a complete family. We're happy. I mean, we love those girls. Mm-hmm. Like if it was we were the bio parent, you know what I mean? And you know, they went through a lot of stuff, and we want to provide that is in the past.
Mm-hmm. They're 12 and 13. Now the girls, are they sisters?
They're not.
They're not. So everybody's got their own background.
Yes. Yeah, totally. Yeah.
Adopting to the various backgrounds, is that an easy thing or is it complicated?
It is, but it's kind of like, I mean, we're learning on the process how to make them feel comfortable, and you know, whatever they want, you know, we will provide it for them. You know, so we're trying to make them easy, the transition to make it easy. Mm-hmm. So.
Mom, three girls in the house. You get to do the hair. You get to do all of that. Talk about that whole continuing to carry on and be a great mom.
Well, it's a routine. We have our routines each day. The kids love it. They love the structure. But just like you said, we do the hair each morning. We make the lunch boxes. Mm-hmm. And I love being able to provide that for them that I know maybe they didn't have in their early years. And they love it. They love the attention. They love having somebody that they can just depend on and trust.
And one thing you said to me off camera is that you actually work from home. So that gives you additional time that you can make sure that they are being cared for properly.
Yes, because with these children, there's a lot of needs that need to be met, a lot of appointments, catch up in school, catch up with doctor's appointments, therapy. So it is important to have, you know, that flexibility where I can work from home some days so I can get them on their, you know, Zoom appointments or their doctor's appointments as they need.
Tiana, the Children's Network of Southwest Florida is always there for these foster parents and adopted parents. What are some of the services you provide to help them in that process?
So once a family has applied to adopt and their adoption becomes final, they're eligible for certain benefits. So the first is, and these are basic benefits. So the first is an adoption stipend. Our families are eligible to receive monetary support until that child turns 18.
Okay.
They continue to receive that child's insurance because that's important for that continuity of care for medical and mental health appointments. They also are eligible for or continue to receive assistance through post-adoption. So once the case is closed, they're not left alone. They have someone they can reach out to and say, hey, I need assistance. Can you help me to navigate certain services that I may need for my child that these needs are just coming up now? Mm-hmm. They also are eligible for a tuition waiver. This waives tuition until that child is 28 years old. Mm. And they can use
college
tuition until they're 28 years old. And they use that for public colleges in the state of Florida. So our families don't have to worry about, hey, I'm taking on additional children. How are we going to ensure they get through school? That's a benefit that's available to them by the state. And so we have additional benefits, especially for our older kids that are adopted. So when you adopt a child 16 and older, their benefits continue until they're 21. So sometimes our families think, well, we're adopting them at 16. We only have two more years and the support ends. It doesn't. It continues on. Those are just a few of those benefits our families are eligible for.
Your CEO over there, Nada Ray Saleem, she is very passionate about this. She's been doing it for 100 years. Nada Ray, I'm trying to age it. But that filters down to staff as well, doesn't it?
Definitely. She champions the adoption. She champions just child welfare in general and supporting our families, whether it is our biological families, our foster parents, our adoptive parents. She champions that. And it does definitely, because once you see leadership takes that much involvement and is so, you know, has her arms wrapped around all of those programs, you have no other reason other than that to, you know, want to get up and do it every day.
Now, you clinically talked about some of the things and some of the support mechanisms that you put in place, but I want you to personalize this. How does it feel to you personally when you see the plan go full circle from bringing the children in to parenting with parent and seeing those smiles on everybody's face?
In a few words, my heart is full. Just knowing that that child came in for, you know, various circumstances.
Mm-hmm.
And then to see what they've had to go through, and then to know that a family is willing to commit, because it takes a lot. Their whole routines are changed, the family dynamics change, but the family is just willing to decide, hey, I'm going to give it my best, I'm going to give it my all, and they commit to that child, my heart is full.
Mm-hmm. What are some myths that you want to dispel about adoption or even foster care?
Only the babies need homes. And that is just not true. We have so many preteens and teenagers that are just dying for a family. They're screaming out and say, hey, I want to be adopted. I want family. And we have the supports to wrap around these families to help them with providing that permanency for those children.
What is the Heart Gallery?
So our Heart Gallery is a traveling exhibit of our photos of children that are available for adoption. And we tend to bring them out in the community. So we bring awareness to our children that are available. We have nice photos professionally done. So we have a lot of professionals that volunteer their time to take photos for our children.
Okay.
Oftentimes we take them in, you know, downtown area. We've been to the butterfly garden, I believe it's called, before. So getting really nice professional photos of our kids. And again, trying to bring that awareness to adoption.
What agency can host a Heart Gallery?
Anyone can, in all honesty. We've had our Heart Gallery in churches. We've had our Heart Gallery in libraries. We've had it in the courthouses. We'll put it anywhere that an agency is saying, hey, I have an event where we'll have a large number of folks that, you know, will be there, and we'll be willing to bring that Heart Gallery down there to showcase that and, again, bring that awareness to adoption, to foster care.
You in quality control under the leadership of my good friend Michelle Farquharson. What are you guys doing quality control?
So, just the overview of quality management is to ensure that our system of care is working, and it's working well, to ensure that our children are getting the best services, and our families are getting the best care, and they're wrapped with services that they do need. And when I say families, I'm speaking of our biological families. I'm speaking of our foster parents and our adopted parents. And then obviously when we identify things that aren't working well, we fix it. We go in and we implement things that make changes to ultimately impact how better our system of care can be.
We're just lucky to have an organization like the Children's Network of Southwest Florida in our community. We're just blessed. Jose, what has been your experience? How would you describe your experience working through this process as an adopted parent with the Children's Network of Southwest Florida?
Awesome. They support you 100%. I mean, this is the good about this is that you're not alone. You're not alone in this process. You think you are, but you're not. You have a lot of support from these people. They check on you, they call you, they provide you the services, and they're always there. So just one phone call away.
When you think about those lovely children that you have adopted, what stands out most to you? What's that little simple thing that you experience at home or whatever with your children that just touches your heart all the time?
That they wake up happy. Mm-hmm. They wake up happy. Every day when I see them doing their normal stuff, I say, just imagine them doing it, mm-hmm. but not doing that. You know what I mean? For us, it's a fulfill. That's it. That's all we can provide. Happiness for those children that they didn't have before. So.
Excellent. Mom, you got three children in the house. 5 years ago, it was the empty nest.
We were just traveling, just doing what we want to do. But now
about you,
a new space. Now we're enjoying this new chapter of life, providing for the children.
Mm. How does that feel?
It feels great. And okay. It feels like we have a purpose and we're there to meet the needs of these children, and we couldn't be happier.
There are people out there looking at you now, millions on this television show around Southwest Florida and around the country now when we got social media. And they're sitting there thinking, I've been thinking about this. I think I need to do it. We need to do it. Whoever, individuals, couples, whatever, churches getting involved. What do you say to them to convince them, hey, this is the time to go out and take some children under your wings?
I was definitely there once before, and I would say don't be scared to reach out. Take that first step to reach out and gather information and learn and make it happen.
Okay.
The children need you.
As it relates to the Children's Network of Southwest Florida, the phone number is 855-933-KIDS, or for kids, just 5437. Also, you can go to their website, childrenssouthwestswfl.org, and people have been seeing it on the screen. I'm going to come back over to you, Tiana. I can tell when you were listening to them, it was just warming your hearts. When people call that phone number or go to that website, what happens from there? What is the process?
So the process is, once you reach out, if you are seeking to gather information, the first thing is they're going to tell you need to go through some pre-service training. We want to get you trained, want to get you information about what to expect Again, this is going to be new territory for you. And so once they are trained, they have an opportunity to decide if they want to be adoptive parents or foster parents. Regardless of whatever direction they choose, they have to get a home study completed. And that home study requires a case manager to come out to your home, to sit with your family, do interviews, gather your background information, speak to references, you know, get information about you. And once they've completed that document, you either become a licensed foster parent once it's approved, or you become a prospective adoptive parent once that home study is approved. And you can use that home study to inquire about children that are waiting on the various websites in Florida across the US. Mm-hmm. And then if you're a licensed foster parent, they call you right away because we do need homes for children in out of home care. So they'll give you a call and they'll match you with a child that's, you know, you determine that you're able to meet their needs, and if that placement happens, and go from there.
There are plenty of children out there. We're going to have to worry about that. Unfortunately. Okay. Well, I want to thank all of you for coming out. You guys are excellent. I want to just pose just one last question. What's the best thing about being an adopted parent?
Just seeing the kids fulfilled.
I think the Spanish family for us is everything. Mm-hmm. And just expand my arm to those kids and hug them and feel that they have a family. Mm-hmm. You know, that's for me, that's it.
Let me take advantage of your Spanish-speaking language. We try to make the show as international as possible. I want you to look into that camera and make the case to somebody who's thinking about adopting, and I want you to say it in Spanish.
Si están tratando de adoptar, este es el tiempo. Hay muchos niños que necesitan ayuda. Así como nosotros lo hicimos, ustedes lo pueden hacer. Dale un chance a un niño que necesita ahorita.
Okay, whatever he just said, I agree with. It's been a pleasure having you on the show. Keep up the good
Thank
work.
You. Thank you.
Remember, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like these fine people at the Children's Network of Southwest Florida that are making our place a better place to live, work, play, and do business. Congratulations. Miami might have the oranges, but the Children's Network of Southwest Florida has got the... Oh, you got it.
Hey, we got it.
We'll be right back.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime. And also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.